morning, children. This is Samantha, master teacher of Kakatiya Public School. Today, I am going to continue the revision on measurement, and in that word sense. Yes, children. Have a look at these words on here. Manoj has two books weighing 320 grams and 680 grams. One book weight is 320 grams and one more book weight is 680 grams. So, what is the total weight of the books? Here, we need to find out the total weight of the books. Total weight of the books, nothing but you need to do that. Addition, children. Okay, so let's add these two weights of that books. Okay, come on here. Weight of the one book. Weight of the one book I am taking as 320 grams. Yes. Weight of the another book. Weight of the another book. Another book is 680 grams. Let's arrange this in columns. Order wise. Come on, let's add. Then you will get a weight of the two books. So the required statements, total weight of two books. So total weight of two books here, grams. Okay. Now, 0 plus 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. Now, 2 plus 8. 2 after we need to take 8 numbers. Next 8 numbers. So, 2 after 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, next 10. Okay, when we are taking here next 8 numbers after 2, we are getting 10. 10 nothing but here 0 and 1 again. 1 after 3. Means 1 after 3 means 2, 3, 4. 1 after 3 means we are getting 4. 4 after next 6. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I am getting here 10. Means the weight of the two books are 1000 grams. 1000 grams nothing but 1000 grams is equals to 1 kg. Yes. Already we know this formula, 1 kg is 1000 grams. So, 1000 grams is equals to 1 kg. Means, weight of the two books are 1 kg. Yes, let's do the next problem, children. To reach picnic spot, we went 13 kilometers 665 meters by bus. 10 kilometers 220 meters by auto rickshaw. Now, and 2 kilometers 500 meters on foot. So, what is the total distance we covered? Okay. This is the total, means the picnic spot here we want to reach. So, some distance we covered by the bus, some distance covered by the auto rickshaw, and some distance covered on foot. Come on, the given distance also. Here, we need to find out its total distance of the picnic spot. So, we need to add this all distance. And kilometers and meters are the common for it. Let's arrange these numbers in column and add. Come on, here steps I am giving here. Distance covered by bus. So, we by bus. First kilometers and meters. By bus, 13 kilometers, 665 meters. Okay. Next, second step, distance covered by auto rickshaw. By auto rickshaw, how much distance here? 10 kilometers and 220 meters. Next, distance covered on foot. Covered on foot here. Foot distance here, 2 kilometers, 500 meters. Yes, the digit is not there. You can take it as a zero. Now, let's arrange this. Let's add this column. 5 plus 0 is 5. 5 plus 0 again 5. Now, 6 plus 2. 6 plus 2. 6 after 2. So, 7, 8. So, 8 plus 0, 8 again. Okay. Now, 6 plus 2. 6 after 2 means 7, 8. 8 after next to 5. 8 after next to 5 means 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We are getting 13 children. So, 3 here, 1 there. Now, 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 0, 4. 4 plus 2, 5, 6. So, 6. Now, 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 0, 2. Means, the distance to picnic spot is 26 kilometers, 385 meters. Let's write here. Therefore, distance to cover, to reach picnic spot is 26 kilometers. Here I am writing 26 kilometers. 385 meters. This much distance they travel to reach picnic spot. Yes, sir. Let's do the next problem here. The height of a tower is 30 meters 75 centimeters. And the height of another tower is 17 meters 18 centimeters. What is the difference in the height of the two towers? Difference means what, children? Here, difference means you need to subtract that numbers. Okay, so we need to do this numbers subtraction, children. And before that, doing the subtraction, which one is a bigger height? Which building has a bigger height? We need to find. So first tower height is 30 meters 75 centimeters, and second tower height is 17 meters 18. Sorry, towers 18 centimeters. So, we need to do subtraction of first number. We need to take it as a 30 meters and 75 centimeters. So, first place this number and second place this number. And meters and centimeters are the common measures for that two numbers. So, first you need to take that up. Come on, let's arrange that numbers in column and let's write the steps here. Height of one tower. So here meters and centimeters are same. One tower, 30 and 75 centimeters. Height of another tower. Another tower is 17 meters 18 centimeters. Okay. The difference, the required statement is difference of the heights of two towers. Difference of the heights of two towers. Let's find the difference here. Now, 5 minus 8. Is it possible 5 minus 8? No. We need to take the borrow from before digit, which is 7. So, 7 will become 6 and 5 will become 15. Now, 15 minus 8 you can subtract, or else you can start counting from 8 to reach the 15. So, 8 after 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So, how many fingers I opened? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 numbers I required to reach the 15, or else 15 minus 8 is 7. Now, 6 minus 1, or else you can start counting from down number to reach the up number. 1 after 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, reach the 6 here. So, 5 numbers are required to reach the 6, or else 6 minus 1 is 5. Now, 0 minus 3, is it possible 0 minus 3? No. So, we need to take the bar over here. So, 3 will become 2 and 0 will become 10. Now, start counting after 7 to reach the 10. 7 after 8, 9, 10. So, 3 numbers I require to reach the 10, or else 10 minus 7 is 3. Yeah. Now, 1 after to reach the 2, 1 after 2 I reach. So, 1 number I require, or else 2 minus 1 is 1. So, what is the distance of that? Distance of the heights of the two towers? So, 13 meters, 57 centimeters. Yes, you can have a look at this problem now. Two bottles contain 200 ml and 550 ml of honey. Two bottles are there, children. One bottle contains a 200 ml and one bottle contains a 550 ml. Of the honey. If these bottles are emptied means into a big bottles. Okay, so these two bottles are emptied into the big bottle. So how much honey will it contain? Means in the big bottle, how much honey it will contain? So what we need to do this problem, children? See, two smaller bottles are. The bottles of honey is poured into the bigger bottle, children. So, see, big bottle. So, what we need to do here, how much honey it will contain. Means, in the big bottle, how much honey it will be. We need to find out. So, nothing but that. We need to add these two numbers. So, you will get the capacity of the big bottle. Come on, let's do here. First, two bottles, no? So, capacity of two are smaller bottles, children. Capacity of first bottle. Okay, so 200 ml. Okay, next capacity of second bottle. Second bottle is 550 ml. So, what we need to do here too? The two bottles are pouring into the bigger bottle now, so it is mixing. Mixing nothing but addition, children, okay? So, we need to add these two capacities, okay? So, the required statement is capacity of a big bottle. So, big bottle capacity, children, ml here. Now, 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 5, 5 and 2 plus 5, 2 after 5, children. So, 2 after 5 means 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We are getting 7. So, what is the capacity of the big bottle here? 750 milliliters. Yes, by today I have completed the revision on measurement, which is included the measurement of length, measurement of capacity, and measurement of mass. So, tomorrow I am going to conduct the test on total measurement, children. So, practice well and thank you. All the best and thank you.